yang pada tahun 2020, seorang pelajar yang bukan sekadar akademik cemerlang, tetapi juga akhlaknya cemerlang, tetapi juga melibatkan soal tempat pekerjaan nanti mereka adalah tempat pekerjaan yang terbaik. Kalau dia menjadi seorang jurutera, jurutera ulul albab yang terbaik. Kalau dia menjadi seorang guru, dia menjadi seorang guru ulul albab yang terbaik. Maka ini yang distrukturkan oleh pusat ulul albab. Dan dia program desain ulul albab ini merupakan pelajar-pelajar yang telah berjaya melepasi peringkat pertama, peringkat kedua, peringkat ketiga. Sejumlah dalam sekitar dalam 200 200 lebih tadi kan, di peringkat yang ketiga tadi, maka nanti akhirnya akan ada sejumlah dalam 40 ataupun 50 pelajar yang akan mengikuti program Designing Fidah ini yang sangat special dia punya program dia. Okay. Ini adalah bukannya beliau ini bukannya model yang telah berjaya mengikut program design Firdaus Ulul Albab ni, tetapi mereka calon-calon ini atau pelajar-pelajar ini adalah pelajar-pelajar yang telah melalui peringkat-peringkat 1, 2 dan 3 yang sekarang sudah bekerja di sekolah-sekolah, di pejabat-pejabat yang mereka bekerjalah, dan pencapaian mereka adalah berada di tahap yang luar biasa. Mereka ni belum lagi tidak mengikut program Ulul Albab, tetapi mereka ni bukan, maksud saya adalah tidak mengikuti program Designing Firdaus, tetapi mereka telah melalui peringkat-peringkat Ulul Albab yang 1, 2 dan 3 tadi tu. Okay. Alright. Baik, ini adalah tawaran modul Ulul Albab, di mana ada modul kemahiran Ulul Albab, ada kemahiran sijil yang saya sebut tadi itulah. Ini adalah kemahiran ulul albab yang umum. Ini adalah berbentuk sijil. Okey. Ini modul kemahiran yang saya sebut tadi itu, MK. Okey. Dia ada dua punya struktur programnya, ada 11 modul. Okey, pelajar-pelajar yang terlibat. Kemudian dia ada sidang paralel. Sidang apa tu, memberikan kuliah ataupun bengkel kepada para pelajar selama 2 jam dan juga back to back 6 jam. Back to back ni program yang bersifat bersemuka di antara facilitator dengan pelajar. Mereka diberikan maklumat ataupun info-info pengurusan perkongsian yang padu, yang padat dengan syarat dengan ilmu sama ada dari sudut Quranik, ensiklopedik dan juga ijtihadik selama 6 jam. Mereka kena ikut. Mereka tak boleh tinggal 6 jam. Kalau mereka tinggal 6 jam ini, mereka buang 4 jam saja, mereka akan disqualified lah. Mereka tidak layak untuk pergi ke program yang seterusnya. Kemudian ini adalah modul QI yang saya sebut tadi tu. Okey, okey, ini adalah Quranic, konten Quranic di mana ada 5 dia punya kursus ataupun sub program di bawahnya. Kemudian ini adalah ensiklopedik, ada 4 sub program ataupun sub khusus di bawahnya. Ini merupakan sidang yang dijalankan secara paralel ataupun juga dalam keadaan back to back, berdepan-depan ataupun face to face dengan pelajar. Ini adalah ijtihadi, ada 2 sahaja dia punya sub program yang disediakan. Okey, ini adalah aktiviti-aktiviti para pelajar sendiri daripada pelajar Ulul Albab sendiri yang turun ke Padang, pergi ke sekolah, ini pergi ke MRSM. Matap Rendah Saimara Ulul Albab di Sungai Besar. Kemudian ini dekat di SMK Kerian Perak, kemudian SMK Sheikh Abdul Fahim Pening, SMK Pulau Pinang, SMK Pulau Pinang. Ini merupakan program-program yang pelajar sendiri, pelajar-pelajar yang telah kami sediakan dengan ilmu-ilmu Ulul Albab tadi, mereka praktis ke sekolah, memberikan ilmu-ilmu motivasi, ilmu-ilmu inovasi, ilmu-ilmu smart study dan sebagainya kepada para pelajar di sekolah pula. Dan ini juga di SMK Datuk Abdul Hassan di Negeri Sembilan, di Melaka dan juga di Selangor. Okey. Right. Okey, ini di tempat-tempat lain, contohnya di Sarawak, aktiviti-aktiviti yang dilakukan oleh pelajar-pelajar Ulu Alba di luar daripada universiti. Kemudian okey, ini lagi gambar-gambar di Thailand dan Indonesia. Mereka menanam pokok bakau, mereka membuat sesi perbincangan dengan para pelajar di tempat tersebut. Okey. Alright, ini CJ profesional yang saya sebut tadi. Okey, ada beberapa.
Terima kasih, Pak Abu Syarin.
Saya.
Waktu lebih kurang 5 menit.
Baik, insyaAllah. Terima kasih, Pak Moderator. Ini yang saya sebut tadi, iaitu program persijilan Ulu Albab profesional. Okey, di mana ada 3 tahap. Tahap 1, tahap 2 dan tahap 3. Tahap asas, tahap pertengahan dan tahap advance, tahap yang lebih lanjutlah. Okey. Ini dia punya konten tahap-tahap tersebut. Tahap 1 ni konten dia. Ini yang para pelajar akan masuk, akan ikuti. Kemudian ini tahap pertengahan. Okey, ini juga para pelajar akan masuk dan tahap yang ketiga. Lanjutan. Di mana ketiga-tiga tahap ini mereka perlu habiskan kesemuanya sekali. Tidak boleh tinggal satu. Kalau tinggal satu, mereka tak boleh nak pergi ke tahap yang seterusnya. Okey, dah sampailah ke tahap design Firdaus tadi. Kalau mereka tak sampai tahap 3, mereka tak boleh untuk pergi ke designing Firdaus UPSI tadi. Okey, kemudian ini gambar-gambar yang para pelajar dapat daripada tahap-tahap tadilah bersama dengan Ulu Albab. Baik, ini adalah selain daripada Ulu Albab menyediakan program-program yang berstruktur tadi, Ulu Albab juga menyediakan satu tapak untuk para pelajar beraktiviti yang dipanggil sebagai Kelab Sahabat Ulul Albab, di mana mereka ada 1,086 ahli berdaftar, 38 orang hufaz dan 3 kohort. Ada 3 kumpulan yang berada di dalamnya. Ini merupakan majlis yang tahun lepas punyalah, 2020 dan 2021. Ini merupakan majlis kepimpinan pelajar Sahabat Ulul Albab tadi. Okey, ini ahli dan okey, ini yang hufaz-hufaz tadi tu yang telah saya nyatakan sebentar tadi. Tuan-tuan puan-puan sekalian, saya fikir saja perkongsian daripada saya tentang apa community service ataupun khidmat masyarakat yang telah disediakan oleh Pusat Ulu Albab kepada para pelajar universiti dan akhirnya akan diberikan kepada pihak luar daripada universiti sendiri. Terima kasih sekali lagi, minta maaf di atas salah silap terlaju bicara. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Tidak kedengaran, tak ada suara. Pak Moderator, tak ada suara Pak Moderator.
Thank you Bapak Dr. Abu Syarin for sharing about the model of community service in Malaysia, especially in example from the Ulul Albab Center. It's interesting that we know about how the Ulul Albab Center form or educate the students before they can share their knowledge, their skill to the community. Thank you for Bapak Dr. Abu Syarin. And for participants, if you have any questions, then you will have the time after our 3 speakers. So you can prepare now what kind of questions that will ask to Bapak Dr. Abu Syarin. Okay, we'll go to the next speaker. We'll say hi with Bapak Dr. Ataur Rahman, the Chairman of Geography Department, University of Peshawar, Pakistan. He's an expert in applied geomorphology, disaster risk management, environmental geography, and also GIS and remote sensing. Please welcome Bapak Dr. Ataur Rahman. Time is yours, Bapak Dr. Ataur Rahman.
Thank you very much, Satya.
Yes, please, Dr. Atta.
For giving me the opportunity to be part of this very important event, the community services program, particularly in your this esteemed university. The community services program, particularly referred by one of our colleagues from the Malaysia, it was really interesting and inspiring for the University of Peshawar as well. Some of the good things which we would copy as well from the Malaysia model. I'm going to share some of the important areas with special reference to the community services at University of Peshawar. Community services refers to a community-oriented work initiated by a person or group of people which can benefit others. It is generally done in the nearby area so that our community reap benefit of your hard work. I mean, the community services, which is very important for uplifting our community services and providing and keeping the role in the uplift of the surrounding areas close to the educational institutions, particularly. In this, more specifically, engaging students in community service with the spirit of volunteering oneself for eradication of social problems and building healthy and peaceful society for all. Community services, particularly at universities, they are focusing on the social problems because the universities, it is surrounded by communities which are living in dilapidated areas. So therefore, we need volunteers to work within the communities close to the university sometime for problem solution and helping the community in resolving their issues. It is an initiative and practical involvement of youth in community service, which attribute them self-confidence and self-responsibility. Such undertaking and creativity spring a natural sense of achievement among youth, which eventually upshots in a sense of pride and identity. So this was about the community services and its definition. But in Pakistan, the social work program under the Social Work Regulation Act in 1974-75, it was passed by the parliament that social work program need to be mainstream in the academic program. So means it was linked with the university and educational institution, and it was kept as a compulsory part of their degree programs. Later on, it was made mandatory, means compulsory social activity for the regular students on the role of constituent professional affiliated colleges, teaching department, institutions of the University of Peshawar, preparing students for the first degree examinations. So I means it was kept as a compulsory part of the academic program throughout the country under this social work programs or the Social Work Regulation Act 1974. So when this program, it was passed by the parliament, then it was mandatory for each and every educational institution to start the community and social activities in the nearby areas. These students have to complete 90 hours, means 90 credit hours and non-credit hours, community services activities during the academic period. This 90 hours, it is spread over 4 years. So during 4 years, the students, because we have BS 4 year programs, after 12 years education, students are enrolled in the university for BS program. We call it the BS 4 year program, where in this 4 year, we have 8 semesters and a total of 9 non-credit hours. They will work for the community services under the supervision of community services coordinator at each and every department. Then later on, the provincial government, they passed the Community Services Act 2014. Every student enrolled in 4 year degree program has to complete mandatory 90 hours non-credited community activities, which was approved by the syndicate of the recommendation on the recommendation of the Academic Council. Means when this act was passed, Community Services Act was passed in 2014, then the university statutory bodies, they also approved and recommended the same community services, and it is also passed by the syndicate to be implemented at the department level. This is the overall duration and spread of the community services program. Duration of the activities is per the Community Services Regulation 2014. The students have to complete 90 hours community services activities during the following academic period. Means in 4 years, they have to complete 90 hours. You can see here the model. In this model, you can see 6 weeks, 30 working days, 3 hours per day. So this is one part, total duration making 90 hours. Only 6 weeks, we will have the 30 working days and then the 3 hours per day. So 30 days into 3 hours equal to 90 hours. So this is all about the further explanation that how we spread the duration. So we start the community services it from third semester. So it is 5 days, 3 hours per day, means 15 hours per week. So means in total 5 months, one semester we have 5 months. So in 5 months, we have 5 days, means at least 1 day per month. So in each month, we have 1 day, and in each day, 3 hours is allocated for community services. And there is a groups in each department, in each class, 15 to 20 students. They work under the supervision of teacher, and the teacher is from the same department. They are called as the coordinator of community services. So in Department of Geography, University of Peshawar, our community services coordinator is Zahid Khan, lecturer, Department of Geography. So he is responsible for this community services at the department level. So he will report the progress to the head of the Department of Geography, and then head of the Department of Geography will communicate and to the director community services of the University of Peshawar. So you can see here, 5 days in third semester, 5 days in fourth semester, 5 days in fifth semester, 5 days in sixth semester, 5 days in seventh semester, and 5 days in eighth semester. So making a total of, you can see here, 90 hours. So 90 hours, it is spread over almost 3 years. So for the first time, it was launched at University of Peshawar compulsorily, and a director, you can see here, this is the director of community services, Dr. Shakil Mahmood. And then Muhammad Sajid, Dr. Muhammad Sajid, you can see here, he is assistant director of community services. Dr. Shakil Mahmood, director community services. Then Sajid, Muhammad Sajid, Dr. Muhammad Sajid, he is assistant director community services. And this is vice chancellor, University of Peshawar, Professor Dr. Muhammad Asif. So a meeting was held with the vice chancellor on 27th July, 2018. Then a proper, you can see here, this is the web page of the University of Peshawar, a specific section it was allocated for the community services program for wide publicity and making enrollment and uploading the activities over the university website. So you can see here community services program at the University of Peshawar, activities going on and already conducted. Community services regulation means what are different rules and regulations of these community services. Then the staff of the community services means the director, assistant director, the clerical staff, and then the director message and the gallery photos, all these things, it is uploaded on the university website for visibility on the university website and for visibility to the students. When to carry out, community services should normally be performed during summer vacations. In Pakistan, the academic institutions, they have 2 months summer vacation because we have very hot summer season in Pakistan. So during summer period, all the educational institution during July and August, it remains closed due to summer vacations. So usually these services, it is conducted during summer vacation. And at the same time, during extreme winter time, these community services also provide opportunities for the students to take part. That the work may be performed at other seasons of the year if advisable, subject to the consent of the Office of the Community Services Program. So means summer season or summer vacation, it is the most ideal period during the academic session. Then, however, this is the responsibility of the concerned head of the department. Means in each department, there is head of the department. And in that department, we have coordinator. Like, for example, I am head of the Department of Geography, and my coordinator is Mr. Zahid Khan. He is lecturer, and he is responsible for coordinating the community services activities. They choose and decide time period and communicate to the Office of the Community Services Program. Means when it is decided, the same is coordinated with the Director of Community Services and the Office of the Community Services Program, so that they must be keep in loop for carrying out any community services activities. These are some ideal times suggested by the Community Services Directorate. One is October to December. This is one period. Then January to March, April to June, and July to September. Means July, August, this is the extreme summer period. So July, August, and September, these are the extreme summer period, and this is the summer vacations. So the academic institution, usually it remained closed during these activities. During these months, means July, August, and September, July and August. So during this particular period, the students are taken into confidence and they were taken to the near and surrounding areas for conducting the community services. So what different types of community services we are performing? I will share the slides and photographs. So when it was launched in 2018, so the vice chancellor and the pro vice chancellor, in the presence of the director community services and the assistant director community services, they conducted a meeting with the head of the departments. All the head of the departments, they participated in this implementation process of the community services program. So all the head of the department, they were taken into confidence that we are going to launch the community services program at the University of Peshawar. So they were guided and proper presentations were given to head of the department that we are going to launch the community services program and a specific directorate it was designated for the community services program. Here you can see the director community services. They are in consultative meeting with the community, with the department coordinators. So these are the different department coordinators. This is the mathematics department coordinator. This is, you can see, the chemistry department coordinator. So you can see the college coordinator. So you can see the center for biotechnology coordinator. So they are in coordinating activities, consultative meetings with the community services program team. So you can see in each department, there are coordinators who are coordinating these activities. Means the community services program, it is decentralized at the department level, so that it should work independently and looking to their related areas that in which particular area they can contribute in the community services program. So they are also performing education programs, free coaching classes for the poor students. Means we have some poor students. Community services and community services also include the education of poor students at the 10th class, 9th, 10th class, and at the 11th and 12th class, means at the higher secondary school certificate and the secondary school certificate. This is class 9th and 10th. This is class 11th and class 12th year. So it government institutions means the university students, they usually go to the schools where they teach English, physics, chemistry, biology, and so many other subjects. Particularly, they are taking coaching classes for the poor students so that to enhance their capacity in education sector. So this is one program. Not only this, but they're also teaching the Quranic educations to the surrounding community population. There is literacy programs. There are some illiterate population. So teaching to the illiterate population who are not educated, illiterate population, our uneducated youth or adults at community level. So teaching them basic writing, reading skills. So teaching to the adults, illiterate population, it is another very important part of the community services performed by the University of Peshawar. So they take the teams to the surrounding areas, to the villages, close to the university and sometime far away to the universities, where we have high illiteracy among the adult population and children. So they go there and they teach the writing and reading skills to the illiterate population at the community level. Sometimes we also organize these community under these community services program, seminars and workshops are also organized by the community services under the community services program. Like, for example, encouraging population for the blood donations means blood donation camps is conducted under the supervision of the community services directorate. Another part is the plantation campaign, means the plantation vegetation cover, planting trees. This is another campaign to increase the vegetation cover and stop the haphazard deforestation. So plantation campaign is also very important part of the community services program. So the student take part in the plantation campaign. We get the plants from the forest department, and then the same plants, it is planted in the actually important areas which need plantation campaigns. Sometimes we also make plantation at the university level to make it more green, our university campus. They also involved in the cleanliness drive, means sometime cleanliness is also performed by the community services students in order to increase awareness among the students. So cleanliness drive is also a very important part of the community services program at the University of Peshawar. So organize, sometime we also organize seminars, workshop on the blood donations, plantation campaign, and cleanliness drive. And based on that seminars and workshop, we take students to the blood donation areas and conducting the plantation campaign and the cleanliness drive. We also visit to social welfare institutions, like, for example, the special education centers, where and organizing activities for special children which could benefit them, like, for example, deaf population, blind population, or blind children, disabled population who cannot walk. Social welfare education institutions, they are also in close contact with the community services of the University of Peshawar. We take students to these institutions, to these schools for organizing the, our activities in order to motivate, mobilize the special children's means, disabled children's, which could benefit from the community services of the University of Peshawar. Sometime for the awareness campaign, we conduct the exhibitions for creating mass awareness against some social evils, like eradicating corruptions. Means sometime we conduct awareness campaign to stop corruption, to stop drug addictions. So these are some other campaigns which is also carried out. And sometimes seminars are organized, workshop are organized, that how to motivate the masses so that should work for the eradication of social evils, like stopping corruption, drug addictions, and some ill social problems. Other activities means parks, anti-pest operation or relief work during pestilence means operations or the relief work. It is carried out. Traffic control in roads of university. Sometimes we have very heavy traffic during some activities. So these students, they also perform the function of the traffic police, means they control the traffic along with the police and along with the line agencies. So traffic control, anti-pest operation, relief, sometimes disaster hit some areas. And our students, they help in relief activities. They are helping the affected population. They are providing emergency response, recoveries. They are helping the poor section of the societies. Relief work in fire, if there is fire incidents, so our community services, they are trained in these activities. So they perform as a first responder. Other natural calamities, if there is any other natural disaster like flood disaster, like earthquake occurs, drought, so if there is fire, so means during that activities, our community services students, they are also trained and they are helping the communities in restoring and rehabilitating their normalization. Civil defense services, relief work in underprivileged or designing and implementing any such activities which could benefit poor segment of society means which would help the poor people or poor community population and bring transformation in society means converting the society into more beneficial societies. Then how we take the approval and how we carry out the community services at the university level. So idea of community development, share your idea regarding community development with community services coordinator. Like for example, idea is generated by the students and then they share this idea with the department level community coordinator. The community level coordinator, they implement that activity in consultation with the community services program project directorate. So community services program coordinator will look into the proposal and will implement if feasible. Means the idea is floated by the community services program at the department level. And sometime if there is mega activity, such activity is sponsored by the Directorate of Community Services Program. But if it is a small level activity, the department organize the same activity, but they take into confidence the Directorate of Community Services Program for implementation. If it is feasible, then it is recommended for its implementation. But if the community services are the idea, it is bigger idea, means we need maximum number of students to be involved, then we call it the mega community services program project approved by the director community service program on the recommendation of concerned community services program coordinator means the department will recommend to the Directorate of Community Services Program this, that we need a mega project to be implemented for this particular type of activity. So this is the overall approval process of the activities. Then progress the coordinator. Once the activity is implemented, then the coordinator shall be required to compile a report on semester-based activities. So I already discussed that there are six semesters, and in each semester, the coordinator means at the department level, the coordinator will compile a report. For the third semester, what different types of activities they have performed. So third semester progress report, then fourth semester progress report, fifth semester, sixth semester, seventh semester, eighth semester. So in every semester, a progress report is submitted to the department institute and submit finally to the Directorate of Community Services Program. The concerned coordinator shall incorporate 90 hours as non-credit hour community service program in the transcript of BS students. means when the student complete this four-year BS program at the department level, then the concerned coordinator, they incorporate this 90-hour non-credit community services program in the transcript, means in the DMC, what we call it, the detailed marks certificates, that this student has conducted, they completed 90 hours as non-credit community services program, and he played a key role. So means they include this particular part in the transcript. Then nature of activities, full detail to be provided. Like for example, when they are preparing a progress report, then the project name, which particular project is implemented in campus or outreach, means within the campus it was conducted this community service, or off the campus this activity was conducted. Any collaboration with external organization means sometime the community services program, it is sponsored by the government agencies, by the non-government organization, by the government organization. So means this need to be made as part of the report. Outcomes, what we achieved from this particular activities or community services activities, then what are the comments for improving such kind of activities in future, and what are the shortcomings, and what were the strength of this activity. Then supporting documentation means written communication, photograph for media coverage, so that maximum population get benefit out of it. Awards and certificates are awarded to the community services program students who are enrolled in this program. So the photographs, and then sharing the photographs on the media, means the print and electronic media, for wide publicity, that this university, along with the curricular activities, they are also performing the extracurricular activities. So then awards and certificates are given to the students. Then the coordinator remarks. So this is the overall progress report, which is submitted by the coordinator at department level. Then who financed this whole process? It's very important for a country like Pakistan and for developing countries. Then every student will pay 500 rupees. It is almost equal to $3. $3 to the department at the start of first semester means this $3, it is paid for 4 years. This is 4 year total fees submitted in favor of the community services program. So out of the total tuition fee and means the admission fee, only $3 it is paid for the community services program. It is compulsory for each and every students. So where this 500 rupees means $3 goes? Out of this 500 rupees, 200 per student will be kept by the department for running the program. So means almost half it is retained by the department. The rest 300 per student will be submitted to the community services account for running mega activities. So students are involved both at the for the community services program organized by the department, and they are also involved in the mega activities organized by the community services program at the university level. So in both the activities, they are actively involved in the process of community services. So means it is self-sufficient program, is not dependent on some other, rather they are generating their own resources. They collect this money and then it is distributed, like 200 per student is kept by the department for organizing activities, and then 300 per student is submitted to the Community Services Directorate for mega projects.
Excuse me, Dr. Atta.
Yes.
About 5 minutes left.
Sure.
For you.
Okay, okay. I'm going to wind up. So this is the overall distribution you can see here. Rewards answer successful completion of community services program activities. Certificates and shields are distributed in order to encourage the students who are involved in the community services program among the students and in charge for encouragement, means the coordinator. Moreover, 10 colleges institutions which come up with real and result-oriented activity will be awarded with certificate and cash prizes. Means each university, they have affiliated and constituent colleges. So the same program is also implemented at college in the constituent colleges and institutions levels. So these are some of the activities, achievement of community services program. So you can see the disabled populations, and these are the students meeting with the vice chancellor. These are the students, they compile a report like mirror of the society for wide publicity. Once the services is completed, then it is published in the form of Mirror Society. This is the name of this community services magazine. You can see here, students are involved in the disabled workshop. Some drama also means the poor students literacy campaign. See here, plantation campaign. You can see here, students are involved in the plantation process at the University of Peshawar. You can see here. These are the students, some community service and some beautification at the College of the Home Economics, Girls College. See here, these are some of the activities. Benefits of doing community services. Give you a way to help others. Help improve your community. Can help you strengthen your resume and CV, means the bio data. Then results and personal growth. You can fill mandatory section in foreign scholarship that you have performed some community services, a way to gain work experience and learn more about certain jobs. You can see here the community services, some campaigns, some gatherings, some activities for the awareness program of the community services. Then achievement of the community services, some sports gala seminars. Also conducted seminars on the UN Convention on the Rights of Person with Disabilities, the Mirror of Society, a bilingual youth magazine. Then Hansti Basti Happy Hood, means these are some of the activities. So you can see here, Department of Mathematics, the final year of community services under the leadership of Dr. Sohail, some community services. The community level. You can see here one day conference on the challenges of the citizens. Some activities performed, then training of the volunteers, means the students are also trained how they will work for the community services. Means community services and Embassy of China, means internationally they are connected with the students and the community services program in other countries. So they were involved. So you can see our volunteers in Beijing, China. Our volunteer in Beijing, China, they are working involved in the community services. These are our students in Beijing. See here, some other pictures at the department level, Better Tomorrow. So these were some of the activities performed at the department level. In each and every department, there are some activities helping the poor students. So you can see here some gifts were given to the students, poor students of the society. Some medical and blood camps organized by the students. So you can see here our student, community services students, they are helping. Successful community services. So they were given awards and certificates. administrative staff. Overall, this is the whole directorate. This is the last slide. Dr. Shakil Ahmed, he is director of the Community Services Program at the University of Peshawar. Dr. Muhammad Sajid, assistant director of the Community Services Program. And Sajid Ahmed, office assistant. And then the Alam Khan, 1P. And I mean, four persons, they are running the whole directorate. This Dr. Shakil Ahmed, he is also assistant professor and the at the Department of Social Work. He is the assistant professor, means from the teaching faculty, but at the same time, this is additional charge. Dr. Muhammad Sajid, he is also assistant professor at the Department of Geology, but he is also conducting these services as well in addition to their own responsibility. Thank you very much for giving me the opportunity. Thank you all for listening. Thank you, Naudi.
Thank you, Dr. Atta, for your sharing about the model of community service in Pakistan. And it's interesting also that we can see the similar context between in Malaysia and in Pakistan, that we involve students and also we involve the lecturers to do the community service program. Okay, so again, for all of the participants, if you have any questions, please you can mind it first, you can write it down first, and then we will have the question and answer session after we go to the third speakers. And now we'll welcome the third speakers of this international webinar. He is Dr. Burhan Rubai Wijaya, the head of Community Service Center of Universitas Negeri Semarang. He is an expert in automotive engineering, and especially at small scale engine. And his community service program is the community development in tourism village. Please welcome Dr. Burhan Rubai Wijaya. I'm sorry, Bapak Dr. Burhan, your voice is not clear. We cannot hear your voice.
Okay. Selamat pagi.
Okay.
Terima kasih Pak Satya yang telah memandu di dalam international webinar pada pagi hari ini. Perkenankan kami menggunakan bahasa Indonesia sebagai bahasa baku masyarakat Indonesia. Mudah-mudahan Bapak Dr. Atta Ur-Rahman. Good morning, Dr. Atta Ur-Rahman. Yang kedua.
Thank you. Jazakallah. Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Kemudian yang kedua, Dr. Abu Zahrin Salamat dari UPSI Malaysia. Selamat pagi. Good morning, Mr.
Selamat pagi. Good morning, Bapak Dokter.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Pada kesempatan yang baik ini, marilah kita mengucap syukur alhamdulillahirabbil alamin karena atas perkenan kita bersama-sama dapat mengikuti atau menyampaikan model-model yang ada di masing-masing negara. Mudah-mudahan pada seminar atau international webinar kali ini kita bersama-sama mendapatkan satu pola yang dapat kita gunakan di masing-masing negara. Karena tadi nampaknya baik itu dari Malaysia, Pakistan maupun Indonesia berkaitan dengan kegiatan pengabdian kepada masyarakat, ada sesuatu yang sama, menurut kacamata saya selaku tim pengembang pusat KKN Universitas Negeri Semarang, tentunya sangat berbahagia dan luar biasa bagi kami untuk dan berkenan sharing pengalaman yang sudah dilakukan di beberapa universitas. Contohnya tadi disampaikan oleh Bapak Dr. Abu Zahrin Selamat kaitannya dengan kolaborasi di Bukit Tinggi, kemudian di Aceh, dan pada saat beberapa waktu yang lalu sebelum pandemi, kami juga diberi kesempatan untuk melakukan community service di UPSI, terintegrasi dengan program PPL dan KKN di University Pendidikan Sultan Idris Malaysia. Berkenan pada kesempatan ini ingin kami sampaikan berkaitan dengan community service di Universitas Negeri Semarang. Bapak-bapak dan khususnya mitra kita yang ada di Pakistan dan Malaysia, pada kesempatan ini juga audiens atau peserta yang hadir hampir mendekati angka 500 peserta yang terdiri dari mahasiswa dan dosen selaku civitas akademika di Universitas Negeri Semarang yang bergabung di kegiatan internasional webinar pada pagi hari ini. Tentunya kami juga menyapa beliau-beliau yang sangat luar biasa berkaitan dengan pelaksanaan community service di Universitas Negeri Semarang. Bila berkenan, kami ingin sampaikan berdasarkan pengalaman sebagai Kepala Pusat Pendidikan dan Pemberdayaan Masyarakat, dan yang kedua, sebagai Kepala Pusat Pengembangan Kuliah Kerja Nyata di Universitas Negeri Semarang, ingin menyampaikan pengalaman yang kami sudah lakukan beberapa waktu dalam periode yang berbeda sejak tahun 2015, program kuliah kerja nyata atau community service di dalam konteks ini telah menjadi program yang wajib bagi mahasiswa tingkat sarjana di Universitas Negeri Semarang. Karena dengan dan menjadi wajib tersebut, maka diharapkan mahasiswa-mahasiswa di Universitas Negeri Semarang memiliki pengalaman dan mengimplementasikan ilmu pengetahuan yang diperoleh pada saat di bangku kuliah dapat diterapkan di masyarakat, dapat diterapkan di komunitas, ataupun dapat diterapkan pada komunitas-komunitas yang ada di luar negeri. Salah satu di antaranya, terima kasih kepada Bapak Abu Zahrin, mewakili dari UPSI Malaysia, yang pada beberapa waktu yang lalu, sekitar tahun 2019, kita diperkenankan mahasiswa kita untuk belajar bersama dengan mahasiswa UPSI. Dan juga di beberapa negara, kita juga pernah singgah atau menyinggahkan mahasiswa untuk mengabdi di Universitas Sabah Malaysia, kemudian Universitas Kasesat di Thailand, kemudian Universitas di negara adidaya atau di negara Eropa yang juga kita mengirimkan mahasiswa tidak hanya pengalaman di Indonesia tetapi juga pengalaman di luar negeri. Nah, kehadiran Dr. Atta Urrahman juga kami sangat mengapresiasi luar biasa pada kehadiran kali ini. Mudah-mudahan ke depan kita bisa berkolaborasi dalam kaitan dengan kegiatan community service program di Pakistan, khususnya di University of Peshawar, Pakistan. Terima kasih atas sharing dan pengalaman yang diberikan. Bapak Ibu, hadirin yang tentunya sangat luar biasa, pada kegiatan penyebarluasan pengetahuan, ilmu pengetahuan dan teknologi, UNES memiliki visi yaitu menjadikan Universitas Negeri Semarang berwawasan konservasi. Tadi sudah disampaikan oleh Sekretaris LPPM bahwa berdasarkan visi Universitas Negeri Semarang tersebut, maka pada pelaksanaan pengabdian kepada masyarakat, penelitian, dan tentunya proses hilirisasi melalui kegiatan KKN, kita mengacu pada visi dan misi Universitas Negeri Semarang. Pada poin visi Universitas Negeri Semarang yang diimplementasikan dalam program KKN, tidak lain adalah menyebarluaskan ilmu pengetahuan teknologi dan olahraga yang berwawasan konservasi, baik di skala nasional maupun internasional. Pernah kita mengirimkan mahasiswa di Universitas Sabah Malaysia bersama dengan Teaching and Physic Learning di universitas tersebut untuk dan berkesempatan menularkan ya, ilmu pengetahuan yang diperoleh di Universitas Negeri Semarang, kemudian disandingkan bersama dengan mahasiswa-mahasiswa yang ada di Universitas Sabah Malaysia untuk dan kepentingan untuk bisa memperoleh pengalaman yang sama. Kemudian pada misi yang keempat, pada kesempatan ini kehadiran yang luar biasa dua narasumber dari Pakistan dan Malaysia untuk dan kepentingan kita bersama-sama membangun dan mengembangkan kerjasama. Tentunya tidak hanya menunjang penguatan kelembagaan secara internasional, dan di dalam implementasinya kita juga bersama-sama dapat melakukan kegiatan bersama-sama secara kolaboratif. Satu contoh yang pernah kami lakukan, kami mendapatkan tamu dari UiTM Malaysia untuk bersama dan hadir mengabdi khususnya di desa binaan yang ada di Universitas Negeri Semarang. Pada tahun 2020 mereka hadir bersama 30 tim baik dosen maupun mahasiswa untuk bersama-sama bertukar pengalaman dalam proses pengabdian kepada masyarakat di desa binaan Universitas Negeri Semarang. Satu ketika kami juga diperkenankan misalkan di UPSI ataupun di Pakistan untuk kita bisa bertukar kunjungan bersama di desa binaan atau wilayah binaan atau komunitas binaan di Pakistan maupun di Malaysia yang merupakan desa mitra dari UPSI. Oleh karena itu, kesempatan pada era selepas pandemi ini kita berharap dapat kita tingkatkan dalam jangka pendek maupun jangka panjang. Bapak Ibu, pada kegiatan khususnya kuliah kerja nyata dalam konteks ini, Universitas Negeri Semarang melaksanakan program tersebut berdasarkan pada peraturan rektor yang sudah diterbitkan sejak tahun 2015 sebagai pedoman pelaksanaan kuliah kerja nyata bagi mahasiswa sarjana, dan ini wajib sehingga setiap tahun kita mengelola untuk mahasiswa dapat berkiprah di masyarakat, berkiprah di komunitas, berkiprah di pada hal ini usaha kecil, menengah di tingkat desa maupun di tingkat kelurahan berbasis pada komunitas tersebut. Nah, yang kedua terkait dengan mitra University of Pakistan, University of Pendidikan Sultan Idris Malaysia, ataupun universitas-universitas lain yang sudah menjalin mitra dengan Universitas Negeri Semarang, kami juga menggunakan dasar hukum, yaitu Peraturan Rektor nomor 1 tahun 2018, kaitannya dengan internasionalisasi. Nah, sehingga dengan dasar itu, maka tidak ada salahnya kehadiran Pak Atar dan Bapak Abu Zahrin kita bersama-sama untuk dapat menindaklanjuti program kerjasama ini. Kita tahu bersama bahwa sebagai perguruan tinggi, baik di skala nasional maupun internasional, mau tidak mau kita memiliki amanah yang cukup mulia, yaitu sebagai agen perubahan. Berhadapan dengan mahasiswa atau menyikapi dengan mahasiswa-mahasiswa kita yang harus didorong untuk soft skill-nya, terutama pada perubahan sikap mental dan perilaku mahasiswa di dalam kita persiapkan menjadi seorang pemimpin bangsa atau calon generasi penerus kita melalui proses pembelajaran langsung di luar kampus. Ini menjadi satu media atau sarana untuk mahasiswa-mahasiswa kita terbentuk karakter yang merupakan ending proses dari kegiatan kuliah kerja nyata, salah satunya. Kemudian, secara definitif atau definisi dari kuliah kerja nyata yang kita lakukan di Universitas Negeri Semarang dalam konteks ini adalah, saya yakin di perguruan tinggi yang berbeda juga sama, di UPSI juga saya yakin akan memadukan konteks pendidikan dan pengajaran, penelitian, artinya hilirisasi dari program yang dihasilkan dari penelitian atau hasil temuan penelitian yang dapat diabdikan atau dihilirisasi di masyarakat atau komunitas. Tentunya ini dengan langkah dan tahapan agar mahasiswa-mahasiswa kita mendapatkan satu pengalaman belajar, tidak hanya di kampus, tetapi juga bersama-sama dengan masyarakat untuk kepentingan pemecahan masalah-masalah yang harus dipecahkan di masyarakat. Sehingga pengalaman mahasiswa tersebut di luar kampus, dalam durasi waktu tertentu, mereka atau mahasiswa kita mendapatkan pengalaman yang cukup luar biasa bersama dengan masyarakat atau komunitas. Oleh karena itu, kegiatan community service sebagai wahana untuk mengembangkan tidak hanya wawasan, tetapi juga soft skill mahasiswa mahasiswa kita, khususnya di Universitas Negeri Semarang. Secara konseptual, kegiatan kuliah kerja nyata di Universitas Negeri Semarang mengacu pada 5 konsep, yaitu partisipatif, artinya mahasiswa belajar dengan masyarakat, berkiprah secara langsung, secara real di masyarakat, mendapatkan nilai pragmatis, kebermanfaatan, baik itu pada lembaga pemerintah ataupun lembaga masyarakat atau bahkan komunitas-komunitas yang lebih kecil di masyarakat yang perlu pendampingan. Kemudian untuk memaksimalkan kegiatan tersebut, secara lintas sektoral mahasiswa kita juga diberi pengalaman untuk berkomunikasi dengan lintas sektoral baik pemerintah daerah dalam konteks pentaheliknya, pemerintah daerah, masyarakat, perguruan tinggi, bisnis, bahkan peran media, ya, itu dalam konteks pentaheliknya. Nah, mahasiswa-mahasiswa yang juga tidak jauh berbeda dengan universitas di Malaysia maupun di Pakistan, mereka berasal dari berbagai program studi. Sehingga dalam konsep KKN ini kita lebih mengedepankan pada konsep interdisiplin ilmu dan komprehensif dalam proses pelaksanaannya. Sehingga keterpaduan aspek tridharma itu dapat dimaksimalkan oleh mahasiswa dalam kaitannya dengan community service atau pengabdian kepada masyarakat. Nah, atas dasar konsep tersebut, maka model pelaksanaan kuliah kerja nyata di Universitas Negeri Semarang, selain kita bernaung di satu perguruan tinggi yang merupakan agent of change bersama dengan pemerintah daerah maupun komunitas di dalam negeri maupun di luar negeri, maka prinsip ini menjadi satu tanggung jawab kita bersama. Dan yang kedua, model yang dilaksanakan di Universitas Negeri Semarang melalui KKN ini sebagai salah satu pembelajaran mahasiswa di luar kampus dan bahkan didukung oleh kebijakan pemerintah melalui Kemendikbud atau Kementerian Pendidikan dan Kebudayaan, Ristek Dikti, melalui Kampus Merdeka dan Merdeka Belajar yang diterbitkan pada tahun 2020. Dan itu sangat luar biasa, mahasiswa kita bisa saja tidak hanya berpengalaman di Indonesia, tetapi juga bahkan berpengalaman di kampus-kampus mitra kita di luar negeri. Dan tidak hanya pada mata kuliah yang ada di perguruan tinggi mitra, tetapi juga bersama-sama masyarakat di luar negeri, mahasiswa-mahasiswa kita bisa berkolaborasi di dalam kegiatan pengabdian masyarakat. Kemudian yang ketiga, mahasiswa-mahasiswa ini juga tentunya tidak lepas dari Bapak Ibu tim pendamping, ya, dosen pendamping, baik itu di mitra maupun di perguruan tinggi asal, yang apabila kita berkesempatan untuk bisa berkunjung ke Pakistan, maka pendampingan oleh dosen pembimbing di University of Peshawar, Pakistan, bersama-sama dengan dosen pembimbing dari Universitas Negeri Semarang ataupun Universitas Pendidikan Sultan Idris bersama-sama untuk berbagi pengalaman di dalam pengabdian masyarakat tersebut. Nah, khususnya kepada peserta mahasiswa KKN pada tema-tematik khusus, kita juga mengembangkan kolaborasi atau kemitraan perguruan tinggi yang ada di Indonesia ataupun perguruan tinggi yang ada di luar negeri. Pernah kita melakukan kolaborasi satu kegiatan community service di tidak hanya di Malaysia tapi di Thailand, khususnya di Kasetsat University. Mahasiswa-mahasiswa UNES diterima dengan baik di sana berkaitan dengan pelaksanaan community service di negara Thailand tersebut. Nah, atas dasar pengalaman itu, paling tidak tadi Dr. Atta Urrahman juga menyampaikan di akhir presentasinya, tentunya kita berharap dengan pengalaman community service tersebut, bersama-sama mahasiswa kita memperoleh pengalaman secara profesional berkaitan dengan contoh yang kita lakukan adalah pemberdayaan masyarakat. Kemudian juga memberikan kesempatan pengembangan ilmu bagi mahasiswa pada kegiatan di luar kampus dengan ending prosesnya. Nah, ini yang kita bisa sampaikan, ending proses dari kegiatan pengabdian masyarakat itu mahasiswa kita memaparkan sebuah artikel ilmiah yang berasal dari atau berbasis pada kuliah kerja nyata. Tidak hanya laporan, tapi karya ilmiah yang disajikan pada waktu setelah Bapak Atta dan Dr. Abu Zahrin menyampaikan sharing pengalamannya, nanti mahasiswa-mahasiswa kita akan mempresentasikan artikel ilmiahnya berdasarkan pertelaan atau pencermatan permasalahan yang ada di wilayah domisili mahasiswa dalam melakukan kuliah kerja nyata. Kemudian yang ketiga juga memberikan kesempatan pada kegiatan di luar kampus melakukan pengabdian masyarakat melalui proyek sosial di desa. Jadi, melalui kegiatan KKN tematik tadi, mahasiswa bisa mengusulkan satu program proyek desanya. Bagaimana strategi pelaksanaan kuliah kerjanya tadi Universitas Negeri Semarang? Tentunya kita melakukan satu tema-tema yang kita tetapkan. Jadi di UPSI mungkin tema besarnya adalah pada konteks di education atau UPSI mengedukasi. Di UNES juga demikian. Ada tema sentral yang kita tetapkan wajib bagi mahasiswa, yaitu UNES mengedukasi. Artinya dengan UNES mengedukasi tersebut melalui learning from home yang lekat pada era pandemi ini, banyak masyarakat tidak hanya di Indonesia tapi di Malaysia di era pandemi atau di Pakistan di era pandemi ini, kita harus tetap mengoptimalkan capaian kemampuan di dalam wawasan di bidang pendidikan. Diperkenankan kami sharing bentuk kuliah kerja nyata di era sebelum pandemi. Jadi setelah tahun 2000 atau sebelum tahun 2020, kita masih melakukan banyak kegiatan kuliah kerja nyata. Ada 7 hal. 6 dan 7 ini orientasi UNES, itu pada KKN internasional pernah kami lakukan. Salah satu contohnya di sini, program UNES bersama UITM pada bulan Januari-Februari tahun 2020, kita menerima 30 dosen dan mahasiswa dari UITM untuk bersama-sama di Desa Binaan di Universitas Negeri Semarang. Kemudian yang kedua, mitra internasional, kami sampaikan ada mahasiswa dari Fakultas Ilmu Keolahragaan yang kita kirim ke University of Sabah, Malaysia. Kemudian beberapa mahasiswa bersama riset di Malaysia juga sekaligus melakukan kegiatan pengabdian kepada masyarakat. Kemudian bersama Universitas Malaysia Pahang, University of Malaysia Pahang juga kita mengirimkan mahasiswa kita short course, jadi mengambil beberapa mata kuliah di Universitas Malaysia Pahang selama kurang lebih satu semester. Tetapi di dalam satu semester tersebut juga mahasiswa kita mengabdikan di komunitas di Malaysia Pahang. Dan juga pengalaman mahasiswa kita juga melalui KKN sekaligus mengabdi di Kasetsart University of Thailand. Jadi contohnya di sini juga di Taiwan kita juga bersama-sama komunitas di sana kita mengabdi di universitas salah satu di Taiwan. Nah, Bapak Ibu, di masa pandemi mau tidak mau 2 tahun terakhir ini kita juga tetap melaksanakan karena setiap tahun kami di Universitas Negeri Semarang ada 5.000 sampai 6.000, bahkan tahun ini kita harus memberikan kesempatan mahasiswa belajar bersama dengan masyarakat, bersama komunitas, di dalam bentuk yang kami laksanakan pada tahun 2020 dan 2021 adalah kuliah kerja nyata bersama melawan COVID, karena posisi pada tahun 2020 mulai Maret itu mau tidak mau mahasiswa harus menyelesaikan kuliah tersebut dengan sifat wajib tersebut, maka kita lakukan kuliah kerja nyata yang bersifat daring. Kemudian yang kedua juga tetap kita mengukuhkan kemitraan dengan pemerintah daerah, kita melaksanakan kuliah kerja nyata kemitraan. Dan senyampang dengan program dari Kementerian Pendidikan dan Kebudayaan, Ristekdikti, kita juga melaksanakan kuliah kerja nyata Merdeka Belajar Kampus Merdeka. Dan untuk kuliah kerja nyata internasional, kita juga tetap melaksanakan pada tahun 2020 dan 2021. Ada mahasiswa kita perwakilan yang di Jepang, kemudian ada mahasiswa kita yang melaksanakan kuliah kerja nyata di PKBM Singapura, kemudian ada mahasiswa kita yang berada di Thailand karena tidak bisa kembali ke Indonesia, mahasiswa asing tersebut, sehingga yang bersangkutan melaksanakan kegiatan di negara di mana pada saat itu mahasiswa tinggal. Nah, sehingga pada tahun 2021 dan 2020 kita bersama-sama menerjunkan mahasiswa di seluruh Indonesia dan juga ada beberapa mahasiswa kita di luar negeri. Bapak Ibu, oleh karena itu kita mengedepankan ada tema-tema sentral di dalam pengabdian masyarakat itu adalah UNES mengajar. Di era pandemi kita juga mengangkat tema adaptasi kebiasaan baru dan lain sebagainya yang semuanya memberikan kesempatan kepada mahasiswa kita untuk belajar bersama dengan masyarakat atau komunitas, baik di dalam negeri maupun di luar negeri. Dengan sasaran program adalah tidak hanya masyarakat dalam komunitas tertentu, tetapi juga bersama-sama dengan pemerintah daerah baik lembaga lembaga pemerintah maupun lembaga pendidikan yang menjadi sasaran tempat mahasiswa melakukan pengabdiannya. Nah, Bapak dan Ibu serta mitra yang berbahagia, banyak sekali produk-produk yang dihasilkan dari pengabdian masyarakat tersebut, di antaranya kita telah mengembangkan bersama dengan mahasiswa melalui KKN potensi desa yang ini menjadi bidikan berkesempatan mahasiswa yang dari Pakistan misalkan. Pernah kita kehadiran beberapa mahasiswa yang di desa binaan ya, di Bergas Kidul ya, bisa hadir di sana dan melalui YouTube Pak Dr. Atta dan Dr. Abu Zahrim bisa melihat atau mengincar desa-desa mana atau wilayah-wilayah potensi wisata yang menjadi mitra UNES, sehingga satu ketika kehadiran mahasiswa dari berbagai negara bisa kita bersama-sama mengabdi di wilayah desa mitra. Banyak sekali luaran-luaran yang bisa Bapak Ibu lihat di YouTube sekarang secara langsung di media sosial yang bisa menjadi media untuk memperoleh informasi yang banyak di situ. Di sini ada di desa Lerep, ada di desa Wonosobo yang jauh di sana, dan bahkan mahasiswa kita dari kegiatan KKN juga sudah menjadikan mereka sebagai seorang wirausaha. Salah satu contohnya ini, atas kegiatan, walaupun pandemi, mereka berinisiasi menjadi seorang wirausaha dalam kaitannya dengan salah seorang mahasiswa yang ada di Kabupaten Semarang, tetap eksis melanjutkan usaha mereka melalui kegiatan pengabdian yang sudah pernah dilakukan sebelumnya. Dan pada kesempatan ini melalui International Webinar Community Service, kita berkesempatan mahasiswa kita nanti mempresentasikan artikel ilmiahnya di setelah kegiatan pemateri dari beberapa negara. Bapak Ibu, ini sekilas kegiatan-kegiatan yang dilakukan dan itu semuanya adalah basis kuliah kerja nyata. Ini beberapa dokumen yang adik-adik lakukan dan secara online mereka melaporkan dan alhamdulillah mitra kita sudah cukup banyak baik dari Kinabalu, KBRI Singapura, kemudian Universitas Pendidikan Indonesia yang ada di Indonesia, Universitas Negeri Yogyakarta, pemerintah daerah, Kementerian Sosial, Kementerian PUPR, jadi mitra-mitra kita yang kita gandeng untuk menyengkuyung bersama kaitannya dengan kegiatan pengabdian. Nah, Bapak-Ibu, yang terakhir, desa yang menjadi desa binaan khususnya LPPM Universitas Semarang. Ada beberapa contoh di sini, Bergas Kidul, kemudian Lerep, kemudian Nyat Nyonyol, dan lain sebagainya. Dan masih banyak kegiatan yang menjadikan desa-desa itu menjadi desa mitra Universitas Negeri Semarang yang dikemas dan didampingi melalui kegiatan kuliah kerja nyata sebagai salah satu kegiatan pengabdian masyarakat bagi sivitas akademika maupun mahasiswa khususnya di dalam mengoptimalkan penularan ilmu pengetahuan yang diperoleh di kampus diimplementasikan di kehidupan secara real di masyarakat ataupun bahkan basis komunitas. Dan itu sebagai gambaran model kuliah kerja nyata atau community service di Universitas Negeri Semarang. Ada Kampung Alam Malon Batik, ini terkenal. Kemudian ada Kampung Layak Anak. Kemudian ada kampung, ini terkenal dengan khas, jadi olahan khas kuliner di wilayah Trisopo. Dan ini juga ada desa dampingan, desa mitra yang mengangkat tentang urban farming, sehingga di sana ada produk sayur higienis, sayur organik yang didampingi bersama kerja dengan mitra PLN. Dan masih banyak lagi desa-desa yang menjadi mitra kita yang semuanya itu adalah dari basis kuliah kerja nyata. Ini ada Desa Ngempon, Desa Kalikayen, dan sudah banyak sekali semuanya berasal dari pendampingan kuliah kerja nyata. Demikian yang bisa saya sampaikan, karena keterbatasan waktu kami akhiri, kurang lebihnya mohon maaf dan terima kasih atas partisipasi dan perhatiannya. Billahi taufiq wal hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, Mr. Dr. Burhan Rubai Wijaya, for the explanation of the community service program in Universitas Negeri Semarang. So we can make a brief conclusion about the community service program in Universitas Negeri Semarang, that UNES developed different model of community service implementation before and during the pandemic. But the content or the activities during this community service is also, or it's still similar. It means that besides develop the potential of the villages, we also try to tackling the social problems in villages that become the location of the community service program. Okay, so now we will go to the discussion or question and answer session, and I will give occasion for three participants who want to ask to our three speakers, or maybe because some of the participants is from Indonesia, so maybe you want to have what is it like a question, you want to make question for Dr. Atau Rahman or maybe for Dr. Abu Zarin. Please, for the, okay, number one, we have Miss Mila. Yeah, maybe the host can spot it, the video of Miss
okay,
Mila.
Okay,
Mbak Mila, please, you can ask question.
Okay, is my voice audible?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, thank you for the time. I want to ask a question to Dr. Atta from Pakistan. Before that, thank you, sir, for your enlightening speech. So my question is, how the TSP team arranged the community service program during this pandemic? Whether the program focused only on COVID-19 or the TSP team also have their own breakthrough. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Dr. Atta, the question?
Is it yes, clear? Yes.
Okay. Yes, please. Maybe
yes, I got it.
Directly answer the question, please.
Thank you, Satya, and thank you for the question, Milaya. During the COVID, the community services were organized at the university campus, because during the COVID, the university was closed, whereas the director community services, he was, and the coordinator, they were at the campus. So the campus was also declared as a shelter point for COVID affected population. So during the COVID, the community services program, it was active, and three hostels, it was vacated and it was declared for the COVID affectees. If the population, affected population increased and there was very little space in the hospitals, so during that time, the three hostels, one for the girls and two for boys, it was vacated by the community services students and the teaching faculty, and that was well furnished. And first aid services, it was also provided to that hostels. But luckily, Almighty Allah saved us from the COVID-19, and that was not used by the during the COVID first wave and the second wave, and then finally the third wave. Now the same hostels, they are now, it is used by the students or girl students and the boy students. Similarly, some active campaigns were, campaign was also arranged on the social media by the community services groups. So they also increased the awareness among the general lot. Similarly, during the COVID period, there was one hostel for the foreign students, and the students who are from the far long areas. So during that period, the community services program population, they made awareness, provided sanitizer for them, and provided awareness campaign in the hostels where the students, they were living there because they were from far long area and from the foreign countries. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Atta. So actually, it's similar in Indonesia. I mean, in the context of students, Universitas Negeri Semarang, when doing the community service during the pandemic, we also give like a campaign from the, for the community about how they can prevent the COVID spread. And then we also distribute, the face mask or maybe the hand sanitizer like that. It's almost similar, Dr. Atta, within in Pakistan, Indonesia. Thank you. Okay, maybe we can go to the next question, please. Participants who want to ask again. Maybe if not from the students, the lecturer maybe also can ask. Or maybe before going to the next question, maybe I will ask by myself, Dr. Atta. You explained that in Pakistan there is different, or you divide the time for conducting the community service. So basically, the program, is it continuous or not? I mean, if it's planned in the third semester and then it finished, and the students doing another program that is different in the fourth semester, or it's a continuous program? Could you understand my question, Dr. Atta?
Yes. Okay. Yes. Yes, I got it, Satya. Thank you for the question. Actually, the programs, it varies from semester to semester. It is not similar. Sometimes there is repetition because, for example, we select a community and some part of the same community or village where the community services is conducted in one phase. Then in the second phase, the remaining part of the community is consulted and the services is provided. So it varies depending upon the situation. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Atta. And maybe I'm also curious for the Ulul Albab programs in Malaysia, Dr. Abu Zarin. You mentioned that in the first stage, in the first program, there is more than 13,600 students participate. But at the last, after the maybe like the selection at the third program, there is only 248 students. So how about the rest of the students, how they do their community service program, or maybe they have no mandatory to do the community service program? Maybe Dr. Abu Zarin can explain to us about that. Is it clear, Pak Abu Zarin, the question?
Okay, baik, jelas soalan tu. Terima kasih, Bapak Moderator. Ya, seperti mana yang telah saya jelaskan tadi, bahawa melalui peringkat pertama, ketika para pelajar mendaftar di kampus sebagai pelajar semester 1, sejumlah 13,000 para pelajar mendaftar, termasuk juga beberapa orang pelajar, beberapa ramai lagi pelajar-pelajar yang lama yang masuk mendaftar dalam program yang pertama. Tetapi selepas melalui beberapa siri-siri tapisan seperti tapisan ujian pengetahuan, kemudian ada lagi beberapa aktiviti-aktiviti yang menguji minda mereka, dan ada lagi beberapa aktiviti-aktiviti yang berkaitan dengan usrah ataupun program kekeluargaan yang dianjurkan hampir satu minggu, satu malam, waktu malam, sekitar dalam 2 jam pertemuan. Dan ada dalam kalangan para pelajar yang tidak sanggup untuk meneruskan untuk menyertai program Ulul Albab ini, maka mereka semakin lama semakin sikit. Dan target asas kami di pihak Ulul Albab memang nak mencari pelajar yang betul-betul fokus, betul-betul berkesanggupan secara sukarela untuk menyertai program Ulul Albab ini. Tidak secara paksaan. Kalau secara paksaan, nanti mereka akan ada rasa tak selesa, tak seronok dan sebagainya. Jadi dengan target yang kecil, memang kecil pun target kami, maka dapatlah 200 lebih itu, barulah mereka dapat, barulah kami Ulul Albab mendapat calon-calon yang sangat sangat baik, sangat cemerlang, sangat bertenaga, sangat energetik untuk melakukan projek community service. Dan bila mereka ini sudah terpilih secara sukarela, maka pihak Ulul Albab menawarkan kepada mereka satu, setelah mereka bersusah payah menjawab peperiksaan, melakukan aktiviti-aktiviti fizikal, mental dan spiritual mereka lakukan, akhirnya kami Ulul Albab menawarkan kepada mereka satu program community service di luar, di Indonesia, di Thailand, di institusi-institusi lain, sebagai satu hadiah kepada mereka di atas pencapaian yang telah mereka lakukan ketika mereka sepanjang tempoh berada di pusat Ulul Albab itu. Saya mendapati bahawa para pelajar yang kecil ini, kumpulan yang kecil ini, mereka sangat sangat seronok. Sangat seronok, sangat gembira bersama dengan pusat Ulul Albab. Sebagai bukti, mereka masih lagi, walaupun sudah bergraduasi, mereka masih lagi berhubung pusat Ulul Albab ini untuk menawarkan khidmat kepada pusat Ulul Albab, kepada komuniti. Sedangkan mereka sudah tamat pengajian, tetapi punya perasaan jiwa itu, perasaan kebersamaan, perasaan yang seronok itu, hasil daripada beberapa proses yang begitu panjang, akhirnya mereka nak balik kembali ke pusat Ulul Albab untuk memberi perkhidmatan kepada pusat Ulul Albab, kepada masyarakat dan para pelajar yang berada di luar sana. Saya fikir itu jawapan kepada soalan yang telah dilontarkan. Terima kasih, Dr. Moderator.
Baik, terima kasih Bapak Dr. Abu Zarin. Okay, maybe we can go to the next question from participants, please. You have an occasion to ask about the model of community service program in Pakistan and Malaysia, because it's interesting. Because, like, yeah, you see in Pakistan, yeah, it almost every semester you have to do the community service program. Yeah, it's a continuous also. Yeah, wow, and it's not accredited, right, Dr. Atta? 90 hours non-credited. So it's a special. I mean, yeah, students have to finish that without credited. It's a different thing within in here in Indonesia, I think.
Yes, thank you, Satya. Actually, it is non-credited. because at the initial stage, we cannot handle the entire students. The number exceed 40, 50,000 students. So handling all the 50,000 students at the first instant, it is quite difficult. So therefore, we have started phase-wise to select some motivated and dedicated students among the whole lot. I mean, in each class, we have 40 to 50 students. And from each class, we select 15 to 20 dedicated students, volunteers especially, for this community services. And it will not be end, rather slowly and gradually, the number will increase. And it will be made as a compulsory part of the curriculum, means it will be properly credited. But this is quite, we are in initial stage because we are in the experiencing stage. Once we learn, we get idea of it and we prepare a good model out of it. So we do hope very soon it will be compulsory part of the curriculum and that will be a credit hour rather than the non-credit hour at present. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Ratha. So actually we can conclude in brief that the community services program in Indonesia or in Malaysia or in Pakistan, it stressing on the how that students could develop their soft skills. Like in principle that used in Ulul Albab Center, head on, hand on, and heart on, I think, yes. I mean, it's not just we develop the knowledge, but also the skills and also the heart, their attitude. And therefore, they will ready to, what is it, to implement their knowledge in community, I think like that. Okay, maybe there is there any question again from participants, please, last occasion? If not, then I will going back to our Master of Ceremony. So, please, participants, no questions again? Okay, so, yeah, I think there is no questions again for Dr. Atta or Dr. Burhan or Dr. Abu Zarin, and then we can go to the conclusion that community service is part of our duty as a higher education or a higher academic community. So it means that besides we're responsible to develop knowledge and technology, we need also to implement our research result to create better community and to build a great civilization. Okay, so I think we have another question. So this is the last question from Mr. Ferizal, please. Yes, Mr. Ferizal, you can ask question.
Okay. Thank you for the opportunity that has given to me. First, we may get some fact from the student participation in the community regarding education that is relevant to the UNES teaching program. There is a review from some people that education is not important and may reject the existence of the UNES teaching program itself, considering they think that work is more important than education. Then my question, how do we convey that education is an important thing to the community, even though the stigma has been formed for a very long time, especially the problem of COVID-19 itself, which makes us not optimal to carry out the program. Thank you.
Okay, maybe your question for all of the three speakers or maybe for who, Mr. Ferizal?
My question is addressed to Mr. Buhan as the head of the community service program at the Semarang State University Development Center. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Mas Ferizal. Okay, please, Bapak Dr. Burhan, this question is for you. Is it clear, Pak Burhan, the question?
Okay, terima kasih, Mas Ferizal Muhammad yang bertanya berkaitan dengan stigma tadi ya, stigma bahwa pengabdian masyarakat ini sebagai salah satu pengalaman pembelajaran yang cukup memberikan pengalaman yang luar biasa bagi mahasiswa yang tidak hanya melakukan praktek secara langsung bersama dengan masyarakat. Nah, sehingga pengalaman belajar dengan masyarakat itu dapat tidak hanya merubah mindset mahasiswa dalam kaitan dengan pengembangan karakter mahasiswa, tetapi juga merubah mindset masyarakat yang didampingi terkait dengan satu contoh misalkan di era pandemi ini masyarakat didampingi oleh mahasiswa akan berubah tanggapan berkaitan dengan bagaimana menyikapi berkaitan dengan pencegahan dan penularan COVID-19, khususnya di era pandemi. Nah, kemudian bagi mahasiswa juga bisa belajar banyak dengan masyarakat terkait dengan bagaimana mahasiswa itu berinisiasi untuk menyadarkan kepada masyarakat melalui pendampingannya, baik secara langsung maupun tidak langsung. Jadi secara langsung bersama dengan masyarakat, bagaimana menjaga jarak sehingga penularan dan pencegahan itu bisa optimal. Kemudian merubah mindset masyarakat dalam konteks mereka harus berdampingan dengan masalah apa ini COVID-19 ini, dan itu menyikapi masyarakat untuk tidak bisa terpisah dengan kondisi itu. Salah satu contohnya itu. Jadi di sisi masyarakat, di sisi mahasiswa itu banyak belajar secara langsung. Mungkin tidak ditemui pada saat di perkuliahan, tetapi di masyarakat mahasiswa tidak hanya memberikan perubahan mindset pada masyarakat, bahkan mahasiswa juga bisa belajar dengan masyarakat secara keseluruhan. Itu mungkin yang bisa saya sampaikan, Mas Farizal ya, yang berkaitan dengan program community service atau pengabdian masyarakat yang memberikan bekal kepada mahasiswa. Tadi saya sampaikan banyak pengalaman belajar bersama dengan masyarakat, tapi juga mahasiswa bisa membimbing atau membina masyarakat sebagai mitra yang bisa diajak untuk satu perubahan yang signifikan, sehingga Mas Farizal sebagai unsur dari akademisi di perguruan tinggi menjadi agent of change tadi yang dapat kita rasakan bersama dengan masyarakat. Saya kira itu yang bisa saya sampaikan. Ya, mudah-mudahan Saudara Farizal puas dengan jawaban tersebut. Kalau ada hal yang perlu disampaikan, nanti kita dapat berdiskusi lebih banyak. Terima kasih. Saya kembalikan kepada
Thank you, Bapak Dr. Burhan. So actually, community service program could be an occasion for students or for higher academic community to make a difference as an icon of change in community. So I think we have a limited time, so we have to finish our discussion in here. And again, the community service is part of our duty as a higher academic community. So it means that besides we have a like responsible to develop our knowledge, our technologies. We need also to implement this research result in the community so it can give a benefit for them, for the community, and also to build a great civilization. Thank you for and give an appreciation for Dr. Atau Rahman, Dr. Abu Zarin Selamat, and Dr. Ubay Wijaya as our speakers today. We have a lot of information and great experience from all of you.
And thank you very much, Satya.
The last and before I close this, I want to apologize if there is some mistakes during I giving the discussion. And see you again in the next occasion, and I will giving back to our Master of Ceremony. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Tidak kedengaran suara.
Sehingga masyarakat lebih bertendensi, lebih senang untuk...
So please check your breakout room to join your room. Once again, thank you so much for your kind attention and have a good time. See you in International Webinar Community Service 2022. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Terima kasih semua. Terima kasih Pak Burhan.
Abu Zahrin atas model yang disampaikan.
Terima kasih ya, Pak Burhan. Okey, boleh saya live YouTube ke?
Ya.
Boleh. Pak Burhan boleh saya live YouTube ke? Boleh saya live ke sekarang?
Ya, nanti lain waktu kami sampaikan sertifikatnya, Bapak. Ya.
Okey.
Matur nuwun.
Okay, kesuan. Mohon duduk diri dulu. Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.